If you're using drugs, you're digging your own grave. There's no hope with dope.
Best to heed the words of the Undertaker, whom we saw before the break. There is indeed no hope with dope. And speaking of hope, however, the man headed to the squared circle right now is hopeful that he will win the Battle Royal this Monday night, that he and one other individual will face off the following week to determine just who will be the new Intercontinental Champion. However, Macho Man, it's you and 19 others, and that's one of the other 19 right there. He's a monster.
Exactly, he is a monster, but I just want all my macho maniacs to know that I will be ready, and I am not going to be denied, Vince McMahon.
Well, you got Giant Gonzalez in there, 8 feet of him. He doesn't want to be denied either. Then from there you got, well, Mr. Perfect, he wants to three-peat. What about Diesel with that hard right hand? Who knows who's going to win the Battle Royal? Wow. Should give you the willies, huh?
No, thank you.
Bam, bam.
Look at him!
You can hear Luna on the outside, that unmistakable voice. Speaking of unmistakable, they're unmistakably Macho Man Randy Savage. There is a huge rift between you and a longtime friend from Hawaii and referencing Crush. What's going on?
You probably know the same as I do. I've made every effort to find out, telegrams, phone calls, letters, whatever, and I've come up with nothing.
Yeah. Well, what are you, such a cheapskate, you call him collect? Why don't you pay for the call? He might answer it.
Now, come on, let's get real here. I mean, what is it? There must be...
Money's not the problem. There's something with Crush, and he's not happy with me about something. I just rather him tell me, iron it out, get it over with, go on, you know, because he's a friend.
Is this something you feel you can work out once you come face to face?
Yeah, once, you know, like find out what... I got to know what it is first.
Oh, you're trying to tell us you don't know what it is?
I don't know what it is. Yeah, I really, really don't know what it is.
Yeah. Bam, bam, Bigelow going up to the top rope. Rod Bell has no idea what just toppled him behind his head. And if he's looking up right now...
That's a form of anesthesia right there.
It sure is in a heap of trouble. And a three count. Bam, bam, Bigelow. Bam. As usual, bam. Impressive
serve.
That was his main squeeze. Luna Vachon. Bam, bam. An awesome athlete. Back to the replay.
Take a look at this.
Forget about it.
Got up there 6 feet high, foot in the back of the head, and now a head to the chest.
Incredible.
Bam Bam Bigelow victorious. Don't go anywhere, Jerry the King Lawler. Scheduled up next, Doink.
Can't wait.
We're back with more WWF action. However, Bam Bam Bigelow and Luna Vachon certainly taking their sweet time. Gloating over their victory.
I showed him the note that told all the things you said about him.
I like that music.
And look who is on his way down.
Oh, look out, Bam Bam. Here
he's coming over here. Here he comes. Frank is coming over here.
Get out of my way. Look out. Get up.
Oh, wait a minute. Bobby Heenan has seen this before. And
Chicago, Illinois.
I wish he would.
Doink with a pail of water. Well, Doink spray Bam Bam. Really throw it on Bam Bam.
Or Luna.
And I guess not.
Even Doink's not that stupid. Hey!
Who was it?
That was confetti.
Well, that's pretty good. That's
and
pretty funny. I like
what
that.
Happens here. If he ever does something like that again.
He's got a hand lift when I get to him.
Luna does not like what happened to Bam Bam. Look at this. Oh, no!
Hey! Bam Bam!
Bam Bam!
seething with anger. Look at it. Root of a shot.
Hey!
Harsh maneuver on the part of Doink. Let it Van Dam coming after Doink now.
Please, Chetsy.
Gets on. Van Dam coming after Doink to town. Back on round and round and round.
Doink can't catch him.
Coming back over this way.
What a coward.
Did he go? Doink just went underneath
right
the
there,
ring.
Right there, under there.
Doink just went underneath the ring. And
pull him out of there.
Bam Bam's too. I don't think Bam Bam can fit underneath that ring. He's too huge.
What if he gets stuck?
Bam Bam trying to find Doink. Is he gonna pull him out or what? No, I guess not. Does it seem?
He's vanished.
Where could he be?
Pretty funny, huh, Waller?
No, it's not funny.
Luna, this young man in the ring has been trying to console Luna, but hey, wait just a minute. Bam Bam Bigelow taking his frustration out of this young man.
Oh, come on. He put his hands on his lady.
Yeah, but this is on top.
That's no lady. That's Bam Bam's main squeeze.
Look at this. Where is Doink the clown? He went under. Wait a minute.
What is he doing now?
What's going on?
Bam Bam, look over there.
Doink the clown is fooling around with something.
What is he doing?
But now he's going. He has a broom. Look out.
He's cleaning up.
Whoa! My goodness! Break the clown hammering Bam Bam Bigelow in the back of the head.
I don't think he should have done that. That's only going to make Bam Bam mad right
what
there.
What has he done? He's tied a wire across the floor. Bam Bam, look out. He's got a wire tied across the floor.
Bam Bam Bigelow, here he comes. Damn. He's coming after Doink.
Oh, my goodness, look at that.
Awesome. I thought he was coordinated.
Oh, my goodness. Look, let's go back and take another look. It was confetti at first, but Bam Bam had to warn Doink the Clown and then Luna Michon. She got her 2 cents worth as well. Look.
This clown's making a lot of enemies. Quit laughing.
Please welcome Jerry.
Should be most interesting. You know, Lawler's an American, you know.
Of course he is.
Well, I want to welcome everybody to a very special edition of the King's Court.
They'll probably kiss up to
now,
Borga.
You know what? I'm going to introduce a gentleman who you people have a little problem accepting. But that's to be expected because you people seem to have a problem with reality. You have a problem. You even have a problem accepting the fact that you all are ruled by a king. Well, this next gentleman tells it like it is. And I think that's why you have a problem with him. He knows you peons for what you really are. He knows this country for what it really is. And he's undefeated since coming to the World Wrestling Federation. That's the reality of the situation. Now let's make him feel welcome. Let's show some respect. Here he is, all the way from Helsinki, Mr. Ludwig Borga.
Interesting to see how he treats Jerry Lawler.
Well, Lawler's gonna need chapstick before this one's over with. All that kissing up he's gonna do. And I can't wait.
Borga. Lawler's not that kind of man.
Yeah, he is. Borga and Lex Luger, I wanna see that.
I'd never kiss up to him.
Apologize. Here they're playing the Finland national anthem, and these peons don't have enough respect to even stand up.
Eihän nää kusit vaan ymmärrä mitään perkele, mitä täytyy tehdä.
You know, Telesikanda, I'm sorry. Please, you must understand, these idiots only speak one language. If you would, I, of course, can understand you. But while you're out here, would you mind speaking in English?
Give me a break.
Yes, of course. I forgot. You morons don't speak only but one language. What I said was, you people have no respect for your superiors. But I don't have any respect for Lex Luger
And I don't have any respect for his friends. And I don't have any respect for his family. And I for sure don't have any respect for this stinking country.
Now, Mr. Borgoff.
Gosh, I can't believe the audacity of that man.
He drove that broken down old bus all across this country, the Lex Express. And he showed everybody the fruited plains. And he showed them the Purple Mountains majesty. But you know this country for what it really is. You tell it like it really is. And tell them what you're going to do to Lex Luger when you get him in the ring.
Lex Luger says he stands for this country. He is like the rivers that runs through this nation, polluted. And Lex Luger stands for the schools of this country. Well, Mr. King, did you know that this country is the only country in the world that you can graduate from high school without reading and writing? Yes, and I'm gonna tear Lex Luger apart the same way this country is crumbling piece by piece because its lazy workers don't do anything.
But Mr. Borga, Lex Luger says that he is the backbone of America.
Well, if Lex Luger is the backbone of this stinking country, I, Ludwig Borga, will break it.
Despise that man. He's gonna pay when he meets Luger.
This tank.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that is going to be something.
One fall.
When the Undertaker meets Yokozuna one-on-one for the WWF title. If you have the opportunity, whatever you do, don't miss that one.
Kevin Kruger.
You know, as much as I get along with James E. Cornette and Mr. Fuji. Wait a minute.
What's Harvey doing to these guys? Harv in that great black suit. Leading Timothy Well and Stephen Dundrink. What's going on here, Bray? Did you know about this?
Well, I'd heard rumor through my grapevine, through the brain vine, that Harvey Whippleman was going to be managing a new team. And this is it. Well done. And it's a heck of a team. And the ladies love these two. Now they're going to love three of them.
Yeah, Harvey's had a bonded reputation as quite a ladies' man. Look at the little weasel. No offense. Present company excluded, of course.
Of course.
A little rat.
Harvey is a home wrecker, though.
Look at him. All right. It looks seedy to me. You know, I was looking on Jack Tunney's desk. I mean, I was looking at a memo, a press release the other day. She must like Well Done. And he had a memo that had Well Done soon to meet Men on a Mission. And that's a pretty important matchup as far as the tag team rankings are concerned.
Well, very, if that's true. Now, you were sneaking and you broke into his office?
No, I had a meeting.
You pulled a Watergate on Jack Tunney, right?
No, absolutely not.
You broke in, bugged the office, and tried to get yourself on the cover of the new magazine coming out. I know it.
That's the only way I would be in a magazine is to be caught shoplifting or... No, never mind.
Well, if you got rid of that Tex Ritter outfit you wear with that 3-gallon hat and those lousy-looking manure boots, maybe somebody could put you in a magazine.
Oh, man, I tell you. Kevin Kruger, good-looking athlete, arm drag takeover on... Is that Stephen Dunn? Of course it is.
Yes.
Of course, his partner's Timothy Well. This is a quick team, very offensive-minded team. Hey, Kevin, he's over there. Oh, clothesline.
That was a setup. And the ham and egger fell for it.
He did indeed. Hook, line, and sinker.
Well, I can't wait to see that match with The Undertaker and Yoko.
Good drop kick. Yeah, that's going to be something. I admire the WWF promoters and all the WWF officials for signing that matchup. Everybody would want to see that.
What is going on with Randy Macho Man Savage and Crush?
Hey, that's another interesting situation, isn't it?
I'm not sure I know what's really going on there. seems to me like Crush is ignoring him.
He seems, Crush seems to be willing to talk to you, willing to talk to Vince McMahon, but every time he hears Macho Man's voice, seems like he hangs up.
Well, that'd be my first move.
Well, I heard that, you know, Crush said he was never going to speak to Savage again, and that's pretty extreme because they were best of friends, you know.
Well, Savage is the one that saved him from being totally smeared by Yokozuna on Monday Night Raw. Savage pulled him out of the ring. Savage, I think, even went to the hospital with him.
That teamwork by Well Done. And they have dominated this tag team event with a variety of very cohesive offensive maneuvers. And now they can't decide on who's going to take the pin here. How about the legal man there, ref? That might be a good idea. How about the legal guy? Referee Danny Davis does even know the legal guy. It really doesn't make any difference. Well Done has been dominant here.
I like those trunks.
Well Done, and their new manager, Harvey Whippleman, victorious here in the WWF. Before we go to the break, ladies and gentlemen, let us take you now to some footage of the latest film of Hulk Hogan.
My guest this week was recently the recipient of what a lot of great folks would call some good-hearted clowning around. With his main squeeze, Luna, here comes Bam Bam Bigelow.
Oh, my goodness, and you can bet Jerry Lawler, Bam Bam is not going to be in a good mood, and you know why.
Yeah, well, he'll be in a worse mood when he gets up close and takes a good look at the mug on Bonnie Blackstone.
Thank you, Martin.
Here, Bonnie.
Would you please be a gentleman?
Whoa, man.
Let's listen up.
You know, Mr. Bigelow, a lot of people feel that what happened to you last week was rather funny.
There was nothing funny about last week. You know, Jerry the King Lawler, you were right. You were right. That no good for nothing imbecilic clown, you know, it was a time when you threw a pail of trash in my face the first time and I let you get away with it. Then the second time, just last week, you threw it in my face again and I let you get away with it again. Then the third time, yes, the third time, you dumped a pail of water over my main squeeze's face.
Tell him, Bam Bam.
Sure it does. Nonetheless, Doink is quite the clown. I don't know that he really intended to upset Bam Bam and Luna all that much, but he really has him in a state of frenzy, it appears. Look at Luna Vachon. She's beside herself.
Doink, you are going to pay for that first pail of garbage you threw in my face. You are going to pay for that rope that you tripped me over.
Yes.
And Doink, you are going to pay dearly for humiliating my main squeeze and humiliating me when I get done with you, Doink. You are gonna wish you were back in the circus on top of a tightrope.
This Monday night, I will be wrestling Razor Ramon for the Intercontinental Championship. And of course, I will be the winner. Because you see, Razor, when it comes to you and me in the ring, you just don't cut it.
Everybody listen to me. This Monday night, the bad guy meets the model for the Intercontinental Championship. Y'all, Martel, Razor Ramon is leaving with all the gold.
You know, Doink, you think everything's funny because you're a clown. Well, I got something for you. What you did to me and what you did to my main squeeze ain't funny. You crossed the line. You touched. You laid your hand on my main squeeze, Doink, and you are going to pay.
Bam Bam Bigelow, did I get under your skin? What's wrong with a little confetti? Everybody likes confetti. And for as far as your main squeeze, Luna, whew, I thought she needed her hair washed. And then you have the gall to say that I crossed the line? Well, you tripped over it, and I'm gonna pay. I'm scared.
Well, whether we like it or not, ladies and gentlemen,
it's time.
It is time. See that one, but this could be most interesting as well.
Once again, you privileged peons are going to be graced with another edition of the King's Court. And I have a very, very special guest this week. I have a man who at SummerSlam said that it was going to be a perfect night. He said that he would have the Intercontinental title around his waist. He said that at SummerSlam he would three-peat. Well, I don't know if you'll be able to recognize him because I'm sure he's got a lot of egg on his face right now. I think he's just fairly mediocre, but he calls himself Mr. Perfect.
Hey, what a three-peat, and listen to the ovation. He would have three-peated if it hadn't been for Diesel. That's the bottom line, Brain. Diesel cost that man the Intercontinental Championship.
He should have watched Diesel then. He should have been more prepared. He should have knocked Diesel out early. He should have had somebody in his corner. Should have. Well, do it. He didn't do it.
Well, he is popular. They love him here. And deservedly so.
Perfect. I'm sure that if you will try real hard, you can think back to SummerSlam. Remember that night you said was going to be a perfect night for you? Remember how you told all these idiots out here that you were going to win that Intercontinental title, put it back around your waist? And remember how you told everybody?
Why don't you just shut up?
I second that.
Come on, tell us what happened. I don't see no belt.
I don't see no belt around your waist either. Here's what happened. Shawn Michaels, Mr. Insecure, who can't go anywhere or do anything on his own, with Diesel at ringside, cost me the Intercontinental Championship. And the reason I'm out here right now, Diesel, is to talk to you. So I hope you're listening.
Wait a minute. So you're gonna blame Diesel, is that right? Now, you know, you say you're perfect, but your mind must not be perfect, or you sure wouldn't want to mess with somebody that's nearly 7 feet tall and weighs in at about 350 pounds. I know you don't want none of Diesel.
You don't know much of anything. Diesel, I understand you're 7 feet tall, and I know that if you could get your hand around anybody's neck, that you could probably do some damage. Well, this is a 21-inch neck, and if you think you can get your hands around this neck, then you try, because Diesel, I owe you, and I don't care how big, how bad, how tough, how rough you think you are. This is Mr. Perfect, the one and the only. And I'll give you right now some perfect advice. It's easier to jump on than it is to jump off.
Oh! Well, he left the King there a little speechless. And rightfully so. Look out, Diesel.
Welcome back to more WWF Action. We're happy you joined us here tonight. And yes, we are looking at a catastrophe. You have to wonder whether or not we'll be seeing yet another catastrophe here next week with a special Savage Crush Summit. More on that a little bit later on. that explosion means the arrival of one man,
Vince Coleman.
No, that's not. Of course not, Bobby Heenan.
Adam Bomb. Who else?
Exactly. And here it comes.
Is he with the Macho Midget or what?
Hey, check this out.
I knew about this.
Johnny Polo, apparently in a transaction over the weekend involving Harvey Whippleman. There's been a transfer of assets here. Harvey Whippleman is now the manager of that awesome specimen, Adam Bomb.
And he's also the new manager of a new tag team here in the WWF. Well done. Managers, sometimes they trade talent, they switch talent, they cut their own deals.
They're parasites, is
no,
what you're saying.
No, I was a manager for years. I never
exactly.
took a dime. I never ripped anybody off.
I was
right up front. Some of the bookwork was mislaid. That was from my secretaries I had to let go, but
creative
none of my
accounting.
Work.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Anyway, Harvey knows what he's doing, and so does Johnny Polo.
Harvey Whippleman, manager of Adam Bomb. No doubt will bring stronger competition to the specimen, this rather unusual looking specimen.
It's only a matter of time till this guy's blown.
Yeah. Harvey Whippleman.
Probably the toughest human being, pound for pound, walking the streets today.
Adam Bomb?
Harvey Whippleman.
Oh, please.
You gotta be ribbon, brother.
There is talk, by the way, that Harvey Whippleman is gonna start his own talk show on ESPN2. Any truth to that, Bobby Heenan?
I don't think so. He'd rather be a success.
I see. Locking back up now. That's Ross Greenberg in there with Adam Bomb. Adam Bomb hammering away. Look at this. Those forearms landing on the forehead. Oh, come on, ref, get in there. Blatant chokehold, a risk of disqualification.
An obvious contender for the new Intercontinental Champion, Razor Ramon, is Adam Bomb.
And you can bet Razor Ramon is back in the dressing room strutting his stuff as the new Intercontinental Champion. And who would blame him if he's right in front of the mirror?
That's probably where he is, listening to all those old Desi Arnaz albums, Babaloo, and calling little Ricky on the phone.
Creep. What do you mean, creep? Wait a minute. You call him the bad guy before. Now you can call him the Intercontinental Champion. That's what he is.
Matter of fact, I don't think I'm going to call him at all.
Dropkick. Nice maneuver.
Sure, that's going to break Razor Ramon's heart, Bobby Heenan, that you're not going to call him.
To the outside. Adam Bomb now with Ross Greenberg as you see Harvey distracting the official up on the apron. Now, and look at this. Wait a minute. And look at this maneuver, slingshot.
Hey, Savage, when's the last time you were in Hawaii?
Not lately. What are you getting at?
Nothing. You can't go to Hawaii. Maybe Hawaii can come to you.
Yes, there will be a summit of sorts here next week, ladies and gentlemen. You remember, of course, the Nixon-Brezhnev summit. How about the Reagan-Gorbachev summit? Everyone remembers that.
How about the summit with Nancy and Raisa?
Raisa?
Yeah, you know, the woman that gave that 400-pound hickey on Gorbachev's head. You know, she used to be a cheerleader at Kremlin U. Not a real one. We just call her Trudy.
Well, of course, everyone remembers the Clinton-Yeltsin summit, but it's all likely to pale in comparison to what happens next week here on Monday Night Raw, the Savage Crush Summit.
No, McMahon, you mean the Crush Savage Summit.
Oh, I see. And in any event, take a look at this. Adam Bomb with Greenberg. Greenberg's going nowhere except up and then
boom!
Right back down, the Adam Smasher. Adam Bomb gets the three count over Ross Greenberg. Very impressive athlete is Adam Bomb.
Here is your winner.
And now, with Adam Harvey Whippleman as the manager of Adam Bomb, who knows to what heights Harvey is likely to take Adam Bomb.
Look at Harvey. He's coiled like a spring. He's ready to knock somebody out.
By the way, it's a special WWF fundraiser 3 weeks from this Sunday night, November 7th, in Sullivan County Community College. Watch Elm Break, New York. The fundraiser benefiting the Liberty Youth Center. And some of the outstanding wrestling stars appearing will be the Steiner Brothers, along with the 1-2-3 Kid on his way to the ring. Here we go. Take a look at him,
Kid. I'm not standing up for him. I was staying. I'm sitting back down.
Would you concur, Macho Man?
I concur. this guy is progressing like by leaps and bounds, and no way anybody can say this guy's on the treadmill of life. No way.
And the handshake.
Oh, you found that humorous.
That was great.
Uh-huh.
I'll tell you what, you got to watch this Pat Tanaka. He is very much heralded all over the world.
Almost ninja-like going through a series of stances here. And a lockup.
Look at this.
Oh, that's a nice takedown. It's right back up the 1-2-3 kid.
Oh. You know, seems like the 1-2-3 kid's got a little bit of, he's familiar with the style. Did you check that out?
Oh, he's trying to act like he knows. Look at
that. Side kicks.
And that'll eventually get to lead it to the head. Missing it. What a sweep that was.
That's all right. That's cool. That's cool. What a match, man. I'm on the edge of a seat right now. I like
what
it.
What a leg sweep by Tanaka.
What a test for the 1-2-3 kid.
This will be a most interesting matchup. It was heralded to be, as you said.
Why
before.
Is the 1-2-3 kid trying to even compare martial arts with this guy?
Well, I don't know. Why don't you ask?
Well,
we won't talk to him. We'll talk to him.
Overblock, nicely done. Off the rope now, over. Went off the ropes and, oh, look at that maneuver. What a great maneuver by the 1-2-3 kid. The drop kick gets being simply on direct takedown into the armbar.
Talk about unbelievable.
Yeah. Action you have grown accustomed to here in the WWF, and a nice reversal. Back and forth.
Oh, right in a chop.
There you go.
This Pat Tanaka has learned a lot from Yokozuna, and he is a master of the martial arts. 1-2-3 kid, on the other hand, I heard, is afraid of even Chinese food. You know.
Nowadays, that's a good thing to be afraid of.
Oh, yeah, right. Watch
well,
this.
I don't know about that.
Watch this.
Watch what?
That right there.
Hard right hand right behind the left ear. And the 1-2-3 kid back up on the forearm and backing off Tanaka.
Big piss for both guys.
It is.
If I was the referee, I'd be worried of getting away.
Standing side headlock now. More traditional wrestling maneuver on the pad, part of Pat Tanaka.
Well, listen to these people.
1-2-3, hear it all out.
Oh, he's heard it a number of times. Boy, has he ever heard it. On the mat, the shoulders pin. 1-2-3. And I bet you don't like to hear it either, do you, King?
Oh, I don't worry about it. You know what? You know what's happening right now? This is the only time the 1-2-3 kid can cast a shadow when he's standing next to somebody. Look how thin he is.
Tanaka coming off. And down goes the 1-2-3 kid. He'll try it again. Coming head-on collision, a leapfrog by the 1-2-3 kid. Oh, what a maneuver! Cover, but no, he cannot. And Pat Tanaka alertly rolling to the outside.
Last time I saw that happen, one of the Quebecers was knocked out and had to be carried out in a stretcher.
Oh, I'm sure the 1-2-3 kid remembers that matchup. Pat Tanaka taking his time on the outside. The 1-2-3 kid over the greedy. Look at that shoulder block. And Pat Tanaka greeted with one on his own right. And
what is he doing?
What happened there?
He bounced his head right off the floor.
Caution to the winds.
No, disqualify the kid.
For what?
Unbelievable. The 1-2-3 kid dazed. The official picking up the count.
I know what he did, but why did he do it?
Well, he smashed Tanaka's head right off the floor there. That should be an automatic disqualify.
Right off the railing.
What's he doing now?
The kid is going flying for the roof to the outside. What a matchup. Pat Tanaka and the 1-2-3 kid. Resume when we return. Stay with us.
Incredible. Well, quit. He just keeps going.
Pat Tanaka, the 1-2-3 kid, having a go here, WWF style. And the kid to the buckle. I wonder whether or not this 1-2-3 kid will be a part of the upcoming Survivor Series.
I'm just wondering whether or not the 1-2-3 kid will survive this match.
Good point. To the buckle again.
That did it.
He's going to be a part of the turnbuckle
Pat
here.
Pat Tanaka.
Hey!
Wait a minute. Did you see that? Clothesline. Where did he come from with that clothesline?
Tanaka just did a 360.
And look at this, the kid getting himself up. Starting with a series of kicks, and what's going to happen now? Back to his feet, maybe not for long. The kid is all over Pat Tanaka. Look at that. The 1-2-3 kid. Up, down, all over Tanaka.
Where's he getting the energy? From the fans.
Now what? Look out, Pat. Watch behind you.
High risk.
On the top rope.
More damage doing something to Tanaka.
Oh, yeah.
Took a knee out, I think.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe the midsection. I'm not sure.
Big turning point of the match right here.
Too bad for the 1-2-3 kid. He has won many a match, though, because of these high-risk maneuvers you made reference to momentarily, Macho Man. And if you have the skills of the 1-2-3 kid, you don't have the size. You have to make those high-risk maneuvers to be victorious.
William, what a valiant effort anyway, no matter what happens.
Oh, my!
He might have knocked him out right there.
Forget about it. What a devastating maneuver. Just when you count that kid out, he's right back on top of you. He's on top of Tanaka. Look out. One, two.
He got him.
Yes, yes.
The match the kid's not given. It's over, but what a match.
The 1-2-3 kid is Pat Tanaka. May never be the same after this matchup. What a match in the World Wrestling Federation.
Both athletes superb, but give the credit to the 1-2-3 kid, Lawler.
Not only did he survive, Mr. Lawler, but he was victorious.
I just hate to be in Pat Tanaka's shoes when he goes back to the dressing room and faces Mr. Fuji and Yokozuna.
And speaking of surviving in the Survivor Series, I am told, King, that momentarily we're going to be informed of your actual participation in the Survivor Series. I can't wait.
Hello, folks. Jeff Jarrett here. That's Double J. J-E, double F, J-A, double R, E, double T. That's Double J. You're going to hear a lot of that name coming up. We're at the Country Music Hall of Fame. I'm going to tell you folks just in a second exactly why we're here. You see, I was born into a wrestling family. It was predetermined. I was destined to become the greatest wrestler of all time. And quite frankly, I've become that. Everybody here in the South knows that. And shortly, everybody in the WWF will. But I'm coming to the WWF for a couple of reasons. You know, my true love, it's not what comes second nature to me. It's not what I'm the greatest at. It's not wrestling. It's what's in my heart. And that's country music, the country music business. You know, I've got more singing talent, more dancing talent, more stage presence, more charisma than any of all the other country music stars put together. But I can't get my break. Maybe it's because I'm a local boy, a Music City native, or maybe it's because the corrupt politics in the business, in the country music industry. Or take, for example, at Fat Boy Garth Brooks. He's a transplanted Oklahoman. He comes in here to Music City, and they try to make him the greatest thing since sliced bread. It just makes me sick to my stomach. He ought to be the Pillsbury Doughboy instead of a country music star. He's making more babies than he is hits. Oh, it makes me sick to my stomach. Yep. But what I'm going to do is, I'm going to use the WWF. I'm going to use you, Randy Savage. And I'm going to use you, Lex Luger, and you, Bret Hart, and the list goes on and on. Because old Double J, when he gets done proving he's the greatest wrestler of all time, the country music business is going to come begging. Going to come on their hands and knees, crawling, kissing my feet, begging me to sign a contract. And then when that's all over, I'm going to come back here to the Hall of Fame. This old sign here, they're going to tear it down. They're going to build a life-size statue. And they're going to make it Double J, gold-plated, life-size. And then old Country Music Hall of Fame, they're going to rename that. It's going to be the Double J Hall of Fame. And I'm going to have gold records. And I'm going to have life-size portraits in there. Don't you forget that. Double J. It's J-E, double F, J-A, double R-E, double T. That's Double J, Jeff Jarrett.
Bushkill? I guess that's diesel music. I wonder if Mr. Perfect's listening to this.
Perfect is a great athlete, but he shouldn't live in the past. He shouldn't whine about what happened to him. If he'd have been prepared for that match, he wouldn't have to worry about Diesel or make excuses. If he'd have left the 1-2-3 kid fight his own battles, Diesel wouldn't have dropped him like with one punch. Perfect, stay in the dressing room. Stay home, mind your own business.
I'm assuming you're referring to that match as SummerSlam, when Big Diesel cost Perfect the Intercontinental Championship.
Now, Perfect cost the match himself when he went out and made a move after Diesel. That's the way I saw it. I was there.
Well, Diesel is certainly an imposing athlete. He's just about 7 feet tall. I think officially 6'10 and a half, maybe 6'11. Well over 300 pounds. And the guy has got quite a brawling background. His former occupations, I know, include being a bodyguard, being a bouncer. This guy has made a living beating people up, no doubt about that. And he's doing it right here, right now, against young P.J. Walker. And remember, P.J. Walker's a guy that upset IRS.
No, he did not upset IRS. Razor the Ramon was the reason that happened. That Ham and Egger was in there with IRS. Irwin had him down. All of a sudden, Razor Ramon comes out of nowhere. He just protected his back. IRS turned around to look at Razor, told the referee, get him out of here. And P.J. Walker lucked into a victory. That's all it was.
Well, it doesn't look too good for him to get a to improve his win-loss record right here. High-velocity turnbuckle there by that big guy who, you know, we've talked about athletes having a mean streak. Well, I can guarantee you, ladies and gentlemen, I've been around this big guy quite some time now, and he is he's nasty. He is bad to the bone, as they say. He has not got great wrestling skills, and he'll tell you that. He is a brawler. He is a fighter. A lot of balance, a lot of agility for a man his size. But he's not going, he doesn't go into a wrestling match to outpoint anyone. He goes into a match to beat people up.
And he beats them up his own way.
He takes his time. He's very methodical, as we are seeing here. I'll tell you something. His, oh, gosh, that hurts. His pending matchup with Mr. Perfect, if it gets into a fist, a fighting, brawling situation, that big man is going to beat Perfect. What's he doing to that glove? You think he would put something in there?
No, it's against the rules.
Well, hitting someone with a fist is against the rules.
If you don't get caught.
Oh, right there, right on the jaw. He goes down like Frank Bruno did a few weeks ago at the hands of Lennox Lewis. It's over. That's a knockout victory. Referee could count to 10 there if he chose to.
I don't think that referee could count to 7.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Survivor Series is just a little over a month away. And now let's go to this very special Survivor Series report.
Indeed, Bobby the Brain Heenan with Crush just arriving, and we're going to have the Savage Crush Summit momentarily. When we return, Bam Bam will be with us.
Making his way down the aisle from Helsinki, Finland, weighing 308 pounds, here is Ludwig Borga.
Hello.
You know, they're calling this team the Foreign Fanatics, and that's exactly what they are, because if you see the definition of fanatic, it's single-minded toward a purpose, dedication to a cause, and that's the way that all these men feel about winning, and they're all successful. The Quebecers, the world tag team champions, the most powerful man in the world, Ludwig Borga, and the anchor of the team, the World Wrestling Federation champion, the great Yokozuna. Now, these all-Americans, Lugers, losers, Steiner Brothers, Tatanka, you're not going to be able to stand up to this combination, because we haven't just limited ourselves to one country. We've got an international flavor. The best from the whole world is coming at the All-Americans.
And as for me, I don't even care about those three stooges out of with Lex Luger. My beef is with Luger. He says he's the American hero. Well, Lex, you better cash your last check, because this is going to be your last bout in the World Wrestling Federation. Because I'm not going to only break your back, I'm going to destroy your career.
So does Nick Banzai!
Yeah!
Jerry Lawler, you're going to bring some knights to the Survivor Series, and you're actually going to have the guts to step in the ring with myself and three of my brothers in what's going to be called the Family Feud. Jerry Lawler, I hate your guts. My brothers hate your guts. And you are going to pay dearly in the Survivor Series for every single thing you've ever said about my family. We're going to give whole new meaning to the word heart attack.
Oh, Double J here again. That's J-E-double-F, J-A-double-R-E, double T. Told you folks you're going to be hearing a lot from me next couple of weeks. You know, I was telling you about the corrupt politics in the country music business, about the wrongdoings in the country music industry. Well, I'm here today at the King Daddy, the Emperor, the Godfather of them all, Buddy Lee Attractions. That's right. Buddy Lee is the premier, the number one talent agency in the world today. But it looks like old Buddy won't give Double J a break, won't give a local boy, a Music City native a break. I guess you gotta be from California or New York City or Oklahoma or Texas, Austin, Texas, Willie Nelson. You know him. What is he, about 95 years old? Oh my Lord, the greasiest hair you ever seen, decrepit. You know old Buddy Lee, he made old Willie a lot of money. Oh, makes me sick to my stomach. He's a red-headed stranger. He's a stranger, all right, a stranger to music. Can't carry a tune in a bucket. Can't sing a lick, unlike myself. The greatest voice in this town today. The greatest singer in the world today. Not only the greatest singer, but the greatest wrestler. And I'm going to prove it to you, Undertaker. I'm going to prove it to you, Mr. Perfect. And you Steiner boys, yeah, I like things in double. I'm going to prove it to you at the same time that I am the greatest wrestler in the world today. And when I'm done, and when I'm finished using the WWF, I'm going to come back here to Music Row. I'm going to come back here to Buddy Lee Attractions. And Buddy Lee himself's gonna walk out that door, this door right here. No, he's not gonna walk. He's gonna crawl on his hands and knees, and he's gonna beg, and he's gonna plead, and he's gonna say, please, Double J, please sign the dotted line, because he wants to tell the world, he wants to tell Nashville, he wants to tell all the country music business that he signed. Double J, it's J-E double F, J-A double R, E double T, Double J. Jeff Jarrett.
You know, Doink, first it started with one. Then there was two. Then the third one showed up. And now there's four Doinks. Well, four Doinks. I got news for you. Four Doinks. November 24th, Survivor Series. There's going to be no more clowning around. Doinks, take it to the circus, because you all are going to go down.
Unbelievable! Yes, don't fall for cheap imitations, and there are a number of cheap imitations around. There's only one World Wrestling Federation, only one Thanksgiving tradition, and that's the one that takes place Thanksgiving Eve on pay-per-view, the Survivor Series. So don't fall for cheap imitations.
Now, let me tell you what was unbelievable about that, was the fact that the Macho Man could get a date. That's unbelievable.
Listen to this crowd! Listen to this response! And take a look what's around not only the neck, but the waist! Razor Ramon going through 19 other participants! And then from there, going through the model with Martel! What a matchup! What a champion! Razor Ramon!
jerk.
What are you talking about?
I can't stand him. Look at him.
Sights on Survivor Series because you've got your hands full with the whole Hart family and Razor Ramon, along with his teammates Mr. Perfect, Marty Jannetty, and the 1-2-3 Kid, likely to have their hands full
right
as well. And right now, this attendant has his hands full of gold.
Look at this guy,
Razor, respecting.
He's got a lot of room. Look at that. Oh, that's funny to you. You like that. He's worried about somebody taking his stuff. You ever seen his car? Have you ever seen Razor Ramon's car? His stereo speakers used to belong to the Moonlight Drive-In Theater. Then he's worried about somebody taking his gold.
Look at the strength of Razor Ramon. Someone who's likely to step into the ring very, very soon with Razor, not only at Survivor Series, but perhaps as a competitor. Perhaps as a contender for the Intercontinental Championship over Erwin R. Shyster. We saw him earlier on. Very impressive, Mr. Shyster. Oh, wow, with a right hand by Razor. Ooh, wow. Look at the condition. Razor Ramon is a proponent of integrated conditioning. A right hand and down on the canvas again, Tony DeVito.
Yeah, he'd make an excellent picture, wouldn't he? Best photos I've ever seen of him were taken from the front and the side.
Razor?
Yeah, right.
I don't follow that at all. The front and the side.
The front and the side. Mug shots. You know him.
Please, Mr. Lawler. You know, you don't respect a lot of individuals in the WWF, do you?
I don't respect you're right. Very few. Let's put it that way. Very few. Look at this.
Razor Ramon having some fun with Tony DeVito.
You know, you asked me earlier about my nights.
Yes.
You asked me, you queried whether the possibility of Diesel being one of them. But I think now that you realize that Diesel certainly will not be one of my nights.
Yes.
Because Diesel will be doing a number on this jerk.
Oh, really?
That's right.
Uh-huh. Well, let's get back to just whom you have chosen for your nights. Give us some idea. I mean,
I'm not going to tell you.
Give us some description of one of the nights.
Well, let me just say this. Brett the Hitman Hart calls himself, what, the excellence of execution?
That's right.
Well, I can just assure you that my Red Knight knows more about wrestling than he's forgotten. Let me put it this way. He's forgotten more about wrestling than Bret Hart will ever know.
Look at this maneuver from the top rope. My goodness. Razor with DeVito. And listen to the response. Tony DeVito, and this could very well be curtains for DeVito. Razor Ramon with DeVito, hooks him up, and gets him right across the back. What strength on the part of Razor Ramon, and DeVito has no place to go, except down. The Razor's edge, and the cover, the count, and the victory.
I'd like to see him try to do that to somebody the size of Diesel.
I'd love to see Razor Ramon do it to Erwin R. Shyster. Shyster's glasses and suspenders and tie would go flying all over the ring.
Look at this. Speaking of flying all over the ring, did you see that grease flying everywhere when he's jumping around like that?
Take a good look at it. That's the Intercontinental Championship. A real good look over this way. Wait a minute, what's this?
Oh, yes.
There's trouble now. Wait a minute. Erwin's entire Survivor Series team is walking out on Razor Ramon. Look at that. Shyster himself, Diesel, Martel, and Adam Bomb.
Yeah, let's see if he survives this.
We're going to have our Survivor Series right here.
Wait, what are these jerks doing out here?
Here comes the Kid Jannetty and Perfect. You wonder if we were going to see Mr. Perfect earlier on. We'll take a good look at him.
Oh, yeah, now he's got three of his friends to back him up.
Razor and his teammates. Shyster and his teammates. The officials trying to get control here. We may have our own Survivor Series long before it's time.
Get up there, Erwin, and slap the taste out of his mouth.
Oh, my, look at this. This may be one of the reasons why the Boston Garden, the host of Survivor Series, sold out in less than an hour. Let's go to face-to-face.
Tonka,
Next week, we're gonna meet right here. And you being an undefeated and a Native American that really represents all Americans. And that's why I'm not just gonna beat you, I'm gonna end your career.
Being Native American and my ancestors being the first Americans, I'm very proud to be a part of this all-American team. Ford Fanatics, prepare yourself in Survivor Series. Quebecers, the Steiners have a score to settle with you.
In the Survivor Series, there will be no Quebec. Providence rules. Quebecers in the Boston Garden, you'll be playing by our rules.
Fanatics, come down to Dog Pound and find out what it's like when the All-Americans get their hands on you. We're gonna make you famous. Tell them, Captain Luger!
Well, as you can see, the level of excitement on this team is very high. What we have is a man who's been undefeated for 2 years at the top level of competition in the World Wrestling Federation, where I think history will show the greatest tag team of all time, and myself, it's an honor and privilege to be a part of it. And let me tell you, when we get the Fanatics in the ring in the Survivor Series, they're gonna see what made the US of A is all about.
Jerry Lawler, you're gonna bring some knights to the Survivor Series, and you're actually gonna have the guts to step in the ring with myself and three of my brothers in what's gonna be called the Family Feud. Jerry Lawler, I hate your guts. My brothers hate your guts. And you are gonna pay dearly in the Survivor Series for every single thing you've ever said about my family. We're gonna give whole new meaning to the word heart attack.
Wasn't that a cute little baby brain?
Kind
of take you back to your childhood when you were in your little pink crib and wearing your little monogram booties.
I did have monogram.
Hey, wait a minute.
Harvey Whippleman.
I heard there was something going on between Polo and Whippleman.
It's a business deal. A business transaction.
Yeah, I bet it was.
You know, for the years I managed here in the WWF, I made a lot of deals with different managers. I always came out on top. Managers are always willing to trade. They're always willing to bargain. They're always willing to improve their situation and their standing. And you can pick up some good deals. It takes you a little money, but it works.
I tell you, fans jumping on the line looking on here. Mike Davis to challenge Adam Bomb. And I wonder how much money was transferred in this deal.
I can find out. I'll look into it.
Will you?
I'll get on the phone with my sources. I'll call my friend. I'll find out.
Take the new ground zero.
Hit the deck.
Oh, that's... Well, I'll tell you something. I bet I'd like to have heard the negotiation between Harvey and Polo. That'd been like, Al Capone talking to Pretty Boy Floyd or somebody.
Are you implying that these two men are not honest?
You're right. You're right. I'm not implying it. I'm saying it. They're not honest, ladies and gentlemen. They're both crooks. And I have to deal with Polo a lot of Saturday nights on Radio WWF, which is not... Saturday in Paradise.
Well, being the host of the show, I imagine Polo can do what he wants.
Oh, he's the host now. Is that what he's telling you?
Well, yeah, that's what he told me. He wouldn't lie to me.
Harvey Whippleman has managed quite a variety of athletes here in the World Wrestling Federation. I don't think none as young and with as much potential as Adam Bomb.
See, the first thing you'll learn when you get into wrestling is get up, stay on your feet, don't stay down, don't let them know you're hurt. Because Davis hasn't been off the mat the whole match. He is hurt.
He spent more time on the canvas than Rembrandt. And look at Adam Bomb. This is a guy 6'7", about 300 pounds. And that big clothesline right off the top turnbuckle should be enough here.
Oh, you know what's next? You have any idea what's next?
Yes, I have an idea what's next. It's over. It's like next is coming up soon.
Well, next is...
Here is your winner.
What are you confuse me now. Next is the King's Court, right?
In just a few moments, yes.
Well, okay. Let's go to it now.
We're not going right now. We have other business to transact, thank you.
But the people want to hear from the King, Jerry Lawler.
Well, the people in Memphis might want to, but they're starved for entertainment themselves.
Okay, roll it.
Hang around a FedEx delivery, the distribution place down there. Wait a minute. What's this guy doing? It's over.
Powerbomb.
Wait a minute. There's no reason for this. This kid can't even defend himself. That's absolutely... Now, he ought to be disqualified. They ought to...
the decision. Oh, Ray, look.
Oh, no.
Look who's coming to the ring.
I don't believe it. What is going to happen now?
He's got a camera over there. There he is, the 8-foot tall giant Gonzalez. Well, the scuttlebutt and the W. What's he doing? You think he's in a parade, waving everybody?
No, there's some serious heat between him and Harvey.
Well, I think Gonzalez finally got an accountant and had somebody do an audit of his funds. And look at Harvey and Adam Baum leaving the ring here.
Well, Adam Baum, it appears to me, does not want to have any part of the giant Gonzalez.
Well, maybe Harvey Whitman has dropped giant Gonzalez like a bad habit.
I got to get to the bottom of this. This is a scoop I've got to get my hands on.
What's going on here?
I'll find out.
Between this group, I wonder if Polo has anything to do with this.
Oh, I imagine he's involved, knowing Johnny like I do. Hand me that phone.
Here you go. I can't believe they're cheering for Gonzalez.
Hello.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time. Jerry the King Lawler!
Jerry Lawler and his night to meet Bret Hart and the Hart family at Survivor Series.
Shh, now be quiet.
He's the king.
Excuse me.
Now get down with me on one knee.
Why don't you people show a little respect to the undisputed king of the World Wrestling Federation? I want to welcome everybody to another edition of the King's Court. And I think it's no secret to anybody that I don't have too much respect for people from Canada. Because you see, Canada is the home of Bret the Hitman Hart. And that's right. And his home.
That's true.
But you know what? I have found a couple of Canadians.
They're not cowards.
That I do have a lot of respect for. And it's going to be my pleasure to bring them out here right now and let you all meet the current World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, the Quebecers. They're great.
Well, they're royal, they are. They're royal pains in the... Stop
welcome
that.
To the King's Court.
Oh, it's an honor to be out here in your regal presence.
Come on here. The Quebecers.
Polo forgot
you
his
guys,
shirt. Maybe he lost it to Whitman in that deal with the Adam Baum.
You know, it was unbelievable the match that you guys had in winning the tag team titles. That was great. But what has really impressed me is the fact that since then, you've not hidden from anybody. You guys have been true fighting champions. You have taken on all the top contenders. You guys even took on the unbelievable team of Barry Horowitz and Reno Riggins, right?
Yes, we did.
I couldn't believe it. You guys are fighting all the top contenders. And wait, even when Reno Riggins chickened out, you allowed Barry Horowitz to run a ringer in on you. You didn't even object. He brought in one of the top wrestlers in the whole World Wrestling Federation, the 1-2-3 Kid, and you guys still kept the belts. You guys are fantastic, aren't they? What about it? Are they great or not? Pay no attention to these idiots. What I want to know is, what is next? Are you guys going to continue to be fighting champions? Are you going to take on all the top tag teams in the World Wrestling Federation?
Well, first of all, we're telling Barry Horowitz right now that as soon as your partner, Reno Riggins, is healthy, you can bring him back and we'll give you another title shot.
What about the Steiners?
Well, you know, the Steiners, we promised them a tag title match and we're going to give it to them.
Johnny, hey, there's a lot of teams in line for this title. We're going to defend it to all the teams. As a matter of fact, there's one team that we got in mind and we got our eye on them. It's the Macho Man and the Macho Midget.
That'll be great.
I tell you, King, like I was saying, we're going to give the Steiners the title shot, but they got to wait in line behind teams like that, behind teams like Paul Bearer and Owen Hart.
Oh, I hate that Owen Hart.
I can't stand him either. We're going to be fighting champions. We're going to defend against all comers, all challengers. It doesn't matter. Anybody will accept. Yeah!
it's like this. If y'all will pull up the belts against anybody, why don't y'all put them up against the mission? It goes like this. Yo, right now, I know you're hot, but won't you give us a title shot? Because if you do, the belts will collect, and we'll send you back to Quebec.
What exactly is he saying?
Wait a minute, Johnny. Let me try to translate that into English. I think that these guys are challenging you guys. Do you imagine? Hey, didn't you just hear him say they're not afraid of anybody? They're fighting champions. They'll take on anybody, anytime. That goes.
Wait, we're fighting champions and we're gonna accept, but there's a lot of other teams ahead of them, and we don't want to be rude.
That's
right. We don't want to be rude and pass them by.
Yeah, right. So, instead of the song saying we're not the Mounties, the song ought to say we're not fighting champions then, right?
Wait a minute! We'll take that challenge then!
Hey, wait a minute!
Oh, you heard that, didn't you?
Yeah.
He said, hey,
wait a minute! We didn't agree on nothing yet!
Well, Paulo may have jumped the gun here.
They're not afraid of you, and they said they'll fight you anytime, any place.
So what you're doing right here next week then?
Yeah, next week we'll do it. We'll do it next week.
There you hear the deal's made then.
You guys
verbal agreement.
Yeah.
That's binding.
That's right.
Well, they better get their attorneys in on this. We need some legal representation.
Come on, throw your hands in the air.
Well, maybe it will be. We'll find out more when we come back. Will there be a title match here next week? We'll let you know. Don't go away.
I'm going to find out.
Oh, yeah.
There's your Macho Man, McMahon. Yes, indeed, that was the last week, ladies and gentlemen. We would like to wish well the recuperative efforts of the Macho Man, Randy Savage, who is watching this program. Randy Savage, unquestionably, to return shortly to action and return here to the broadcast booth, unfortunately, thanks to that man right there. Randy Savage suffering the effects of a lacerated tongue.
Speaking of that, you know, I saw him the other day standing out front of Nate Niles Delicatessen in Beverly Hills.
Randy Savage?
Yes, he heard they had a sale on tongue.
Don't start this week. That's no laughing matter. Do not start that.
You know what he said? He was standing there with the maitre d'. He said, oh, yeah, you dig it? You see, he can't talk.
A very, very painful injury. We all can relate to that lacerated tongue. We all, from time to time, have bitten our tongue before. I wish you'd bite yours, Bobby. Phil Apollo opposing the mighty Crush. And Crush wasting no time at all using his aggressive tactics.
Think he had any trouble eating Slim Jims with a bad tongue?
Apollo the dropkick. Phil Apollo back up. Trips him across the jaw. Apollo. Oh, wait a minute. Quick and fat. Crush catching those punches in midair and now making Apollo suffer.
You know, you can see Mr. Fuji's influence here, McMahon. Because he doesn't have that smile like he used to have when Crush would walk down the aisle.
Oh!
Now it's just determination in those eyes. He doesn't want to beat anybody up with a combination of holds. He wants to put somebody in the hospital.
Crush was an awesome threat before. Look at this! Beating up with Mr. Fuji. But now when you take a look at his physical characteristics, 6'7", he has a 91-pound weight advantage over Phil Apollo. And with Mr. Fuji's mind behind that brawn. Oh, my.
Oh. And he has a whole tongue in his head.
All right.
You know, dig it.
I could not believe, along with, I believe, the majority of the of the world watching what was happening last week, because I thought Randy Savage had talked some sense into Crush. Crush merely was setting up Randy Savage the whole time. He and Mr. Fuji, and then the insult added to the injury. Yokozuna, what an unbelievable conspiracy that we saw last week.
Well, what about Savage's conspiracy?
What are you talking about?
How come he didn't help Crush when he was injured? He pulled him out of the ring after the fourth time, right? After Yokozuna dropped on him four times. Would you let your best friend get hit by a car four times? No, you'd pull him out of the way. Savage was using Crush. He was stabbing him in the back. He was jealous of this man. That's what happened, McMahon. Ding it.
I'm sorry, Bobby Heenan. I don't see it that way at all.
Well, I'm lucky now. I got rid of one of my broadcast colleagues.
I beg your pardon?
I got rid of Beavis now. I just got to find out how to get rid of you, butthead. And the whole show's mine.
Way up above Phil Apollo.
Whoa.
Crush just drops him down to the canvas. And Crush Squash getting a bit of instruction from Mr. Fuji on the outside. Crush waiting, slapping that submission hold on Filippalo. Crush with unbelievable strength, and down goes Apollo.
And I've seen people try to jump in the air, try to kick out of this. This man's hands are like a vice, like a steel vice.
Here is your winner, Crush.
Crush is victorious. And Randy Savage, we know you're looking on.
Wait a minute.
What?
We got Randy on headset here. Yeah. Oh, he's going to talk about Mr. Fuji and the flag. Just a minute. Go ahead, Savage.
Mr. Fuji and now waving the flag. And he's in the ring with Quest, the man that hurt my tongue.
Up next, ladies and gentlemen, Marty Jannetty opposing the 1-2-3 Kid. Now, those two are going to be tag team partners at the Survivor Series. But here on Monday Night Raw, oh, look at that. They will oppose each other. Anything can happen on Monday Night Raw. Standing by with a comment on that matchup, Johnny Polo.
Oh, yeah.
Marty Jannetty versus the 1-2-3 Kid. Ooh, what a bunch of roughhousers. That's going to be a manly contest. Ooh, stop it. Ooh, ooh, that hurts. Ooh, ooh. Man, I'm a manager and I could beat either one of those two. Heck, I could beat them both with both arms tied behind my back. What a bunch of losers.
This way. Oh, how lucky we are, McMahon. He's making it to our table. What a privilege. What a pleasure this is going to be. I'm going to see if I can get a word with Ludwig Borga. Mr. Borga, may I be the first to congratulate you on still being undefeated here in the World Wrestling Federation?
Don't use the word still, so, you know, because I'm going to always be undefeated. And next week, I'm going to meet the Native American, who is also undefeated.
This weekend, Tatanka, you know, his record, nobody's ever had a record like Tatanka's.
He had a good record, but the record is going to stop at Ludwig Borga. Because only one of us can step out of that ring undefeated. And Mr. Heenan, I'm not going to only defeat Tatanka, the American native. I'm going to end his career, right? I'm going to end the American dream.
Well, if you're smart, you'll put your money on Ludwig Borga and say bye-bye to Tatanka.
We'll be right back with more with Men on a Mission.
You All-Americans have never been more ready than they are right now for the Survivor Series this Thanksgiving Eve. And you know, Tatanka's got a match going on later this hour, as do the Steiner brothers, yes, and they're going to show exactly how ready they really are.
That's right. Foreign Fanatics, pay attention to our match later on, and you will see that the Steiner brothers have never been more psyched, more focused than they are for the Survivor Series.
You see, boys, it's going to get wild and crazy in the dog pound. You see, we're gladiators. That makes us survivors. It sure is God's green earth. As sure as the heartbeat of America, we're going to be survivors in the Survivor Series.
So, guys, Ludwig Borga says he's going to start eliminating people this week. Well, we're going to be watching Tatanka's match. We're going to be watching each other's backs. And when it comes to Survivor Series, we're going to be the ones who survive.
Come on, boys!
WWF Action Day!
Oh, my. Listen to this.
It's scheduled for one fall.
Oh, yeah. And take a look at that.
To the ring.
One lovely lady.
Hey, look out behind you, Bammer. What is it?
Hey, stupid Sparky! Look behind you!
Hey, wait a minute. Look at this.
Look what I got! Can you tell what these are? These are two buckets. One for you. And one for Luna.
Where is he?
What, the biggest surprise of all? Survivor Series? You'll see four buckets.
Where did he go?
Buck has disappeared.
Where was he anyway?
I don't know, but Bam Bam Bigelow is really upset. I would not want to be Bam Bam Bigelow's opponent.
From Amherst,
but who knows? Maybe Doink is going to come out around ringside. You never can tell.
Tim
with Doink the Clown.
I think it would be wise right now for Luna or Bam Bam to check under the ring. There could be three or four of them right under there.
No telling how many Doinks there are.
Check under a rock because that's where he belongs.
Bam Bam still upset over what happened. Doink the Clown dumping a bucket of water over Luna Vachon, setting up the trip for Bammer himself to be embarrassed. Oh, my. McNeary. My goodness.
Oh, yes.
I hope she stays home this weekend here in the United States. It's Halloween, and he's always dressed for Halloween. Look at that. The cover. This one's over quickly. Bam Bam Bigelow. Pretty much manhandling Tim McNeary. And you wonder, would he do the same thing given the opportunity in single competition to Doink the Clown?
Well, I don't know about single competition, but I can tell you what he'll do to four of them at Survivor Series. And I know you want to be there, Vince McMahon. And you start. You get in your little car right there in Stamford, Connecticut at the WWF headquarters. You head up I-95. You'll go right through New Haven, Connecticut. That's it right there. And then you just keep on I-95 up to Providence. And then you sort of take a little right-hand turn. You'll get near Boston, and then you go right down through the Sumner Tunnel. And then, bang, you're there, right in Boston at the Boston Gardens. And that's where Survivor Series will take place. And bam, bam, we'll do in the Doinks.
Well, I hate to have to say this, but it is time now to face to face. Everyone looking forward to the Survivor Series, the pay-per-view tradition, the pay-per-view Thanksgiving tradition on Thanksgiving Eve. As we've said before, don't fall for cheap imitations. This man here, obviously no cheap imitation of anything. Ludwig Borga getting set to square off against the undefeated Native American Tatanka. We had an occasion to pick up these pre-recorded comments earlier on with Ludwig Borga. He's ready for the match.
Tatanka, you represent all the Americans. And undefeated? Well, in few minutes, I'm not just gonna beat you. I'm gonna destroy you.
Tatanka will be put to the test, and so will Ludwig Borga. When we return, our feature matchup this week, it's gonna be a humdinger. Stay with us. Well, just like Lex Luger said, America, love it or leave it. And there's a man who can leave, Ludwig Borga. And speaking of Americans, here comes a Native American. What a matchup this is going to be. Elimination tag team matchup at the Survivor Series, but now it's one-on-one. Tatanka, being the competitor that he is, putting his undefeated streak on the line against the individual from Helsinki, Pick'em Time, King.
Well, I can just tell you this. This is not going to be a happy Halloween for Tonto, because Ludwig Borga is fixing to do something to him that he has never had done before. He's experienced the thrill of victory many times, but never the agony of defeat. And he's fixing to see it.
I see. You can bet that Lex Luger is looking on.
You think so?
No question of that.
I hope he doesn't run out here and try to interfere in this match. It'd be just like something he would do. You know?
Oh, please.
He's a backfighter.
Would you please? Locking up now, Ludwig Borga. It's a tough cheap shot there to the river. Oh, look at that one, another one. Come on, Rap. Open those hands. Look at this.
He's lifting him right up.
Punch
the
after
mat.
Punch with a clinched fist. Borga lifting the knee out of the midsection. And another one. Ludwig Borga all over Tatanka here in the early stages to the buckle. Borga moving in, but missing. Tatanka with a chop. Tatanka with another chop. Borga still on his feet. I can't believe it.
Maybe not for long now.
Tatanka whips it in a row. Quick from the come off. Yes, a close line. He's still on his feet.
He cannot get the man down.
Tatanka.
Look at this. He's hitting with everything he's got.
I can't believe this. Borga is a monster. Tatanka with a clothesline, and finally Ludwig Borga hammered down to the cap.
Yeah, but look at Borga's face. I think that only made him mad. He's not hurt.
You might be right. And do we see a look of concern in the face of Tatanka?
No, that's flat-out fear.
He is scared to death right now.
Well, you can bet that both men really have a great deal of more respect for each other right now.
I know this for a fact, that when Tatanka was sitting back in the dressing room before this match, he was chewing his fingernails so much that his stomach needs a manicure now.
Never mind, it's Halloween weekend. And you look ridiculous in that Macho Man outfit.
This kid just came up and asked me for an autograph. He thought I was the Macho Man. And then he got close, and he saw my crown sitting here, and he knew that he was speaking to royalty.
I see. Shoulder block. I can't believe this Borga. My goodness, he's like a giant oak tree. Borga from Helsinki. What a matchup this is. Pataka off the rope again. Oh, look at this.
Look at that. Go ahead. He's done you. Shoot your best shot. Let's see what you got, Indian.
Borga challenging Pataka to try it again. He does off the rope. Roundhouse right misses. Pataka from the far side, and Borga almost knocked off his feet. Drop kick in there. Big man still doesn't go down. He's only down on one knee. Back up now. Pataka. Yes. One, two, he gets it.
No, three. No.
So close. So very, very close. Well, perhaps now Ludwig Borga. Look at that look on his face.
Oh,
he's embarrassed.
No, he's not. He's upset. He's angry. Hey.
And listen to this chant that really gets under his skin. USA!
Would you mind standing up and telling these people to be quiet? The man needs to concentrate here in this match.
I see. Well, we're going to find out whether or not Ludwig Borga is going to be trick-or-treating after this matchup is over.
Speaking of trick-or-treating, with that suit you got on, I bet you go trick-or-treating as is.
What's wrong with the way I look?
I bet you, where do you get your clothes? You steal them from
Never
a scarecrow?
Never mind, let's go back to the action here. Ludwig Borga wanting to mix it up fisticuff style, and the referee finally saying, Mr. Borga, this is not your championship boxing days.
Look
this is the World Wrestling Federation.
Who is he looking for? I think he's looking for Lex Luger to come and help him.
No, I don't think so at all. Oh, look at that. And again, we saw that shot. Come on, ref, get in there.
That could break some ribs, don't you think?
No kidding. Alter rope to Taka. Elbow missing from the far side down. Oh, no. Ludwig Borga doubling up to Taka. An unbelievable right hand. You can hear that smack of the flesh resounding off the arena wall. Ludwig Borga pouring it on here. What a powerhouse this guy is. Oh, come on. Get down to action. With Tatanka now, hammers again. I must say the official is warning Borga time after time after time. Why not disqualify him?
Oh, you'd like that cheap win for Tonto, wouldn't you?
Uh-oh, look at this. Tatanka slammed down in a canvas. And yet more damage to the abdomen and back. Wait a minute. What's Mr. Fuji doing? What's Mr. Fuji doing coming out of the ringside?
He's coming out to get a closer view of the match.
He has no business out here.
He's probably standing up there blocking his view. I can barely see myself.
This isn't the Survivor Series. What is he doing out there? Borga with Tatanka in the ring. From baseline. Look at this. Oh, he's going to go up. Up goes Tatanka. We've seen this before. Borga making him think about it. Down to the canvas. Ludwig Borga. Get Fuji out of there. Superstars in the matchup has continued. Ludwig Borga and Tatanka going at it. Ludwig Borga pouring it on Tatanka. Look at this. Would you? Wearing him down bit by bit. Ludwig the powerhouse. The battle of the unbeatens here. Borga riding Tatanka, leaning on that 300-pound carcass down on him. Anti-American epithets.
Well, I made my pick earlier. Let's see you make your pick now, huh? Go ahead, admit it. You know that Borga's gonna beat him. Look at this.
I don't know anything of the kind.
He doesn't have a chance.
Oh, never count out Tatanka. Never count him out. He has unbelievable spirit. Unbelievable tenacity. And Tatanka back up to his feet. And Borga goes up. And yes! Great suplex by Tatanka. Quite like this Ludwig Borga.
he's fixing to run right over that Indy. Look at this. Got him again.
And again, right back to what has worked. And if I were the official, I certainly would be checking the proximity of the forearm to make sure it doesn't slip underneath the chin into a choke. Imagine this tank, this Helsinki tank Borga, teaming up with Yokozuna at the Survivor Series.
Unstoppable.
Dropping the leg, Ludwig Borga. I've never seen anything quite like this. Tatanka has been pummeled thus far. Thanks to Ludwig Borga, and I also might add, thanks to a bit of, I believe, sloppy officiating.
Oh, now you're going to blame the referee.
Well, come on. You saw the clinched fist, and you know the devastating punch of Ludwig Borga.
Well, what about when Tatanka starts dancing around the ring and throwing those chops left and right?
What about difference?
Well, that's just as illegal as a fist.
And Fuji on the outside, shouting instructions on Ludwig Borga.
He's merely offering support.
And look at this. Hard chop.
There you go. Where's the referee now?
And another one. Those illegal blows on another one. Tatanka trying to chop down the big man. Tatanka. Locked in again. That right hand finds its mark. And I believe severe damage has been done to the lower rib area. Oh, no, into the kidneys again.
It won't be long now, I can assure you. Can I start singing? Turn out the light.
Please.
Look at this.
Tatanka to the buckle again, and Tatanka, then he is standing up.
And he got
Tatanka back on his feet. And Borga trying to slow him down. Borga can't believe what's going on with the Native American. Tatanka now off the rope and missing with a roundhouse, moving right on target. Tatanka. Tatanka winds up another chop.
Oh, unbelievable. Got him again, right in the side.
Borga with Tatanka now, has him up and peeking over the top rope to the outside. I can't believe that.
Like a feather. Like a feather.
I can't believe Borga heaving Tatanka over the top. And wait a minute, what's Mr. Fuji coming close to Tatanka? The official out there between Mr. Fuji and Tatanka. Meanwhile, what's this? Borga from behind the official's back has found the chair.
Standing up my way.
Ludwig Borga coming back into the ring. Smile on Mr. Fuji. And Tatanka is out. He's unconscious.
Count him out. Referee, count him out.
Tatanka's not moving. Borga now. Out with the Native American. Trying to get him out.
Always the gentleman. Going to help me back in the ring.
It appears to me Tatanka is out. He's out cold. He's still unconscious. Chair behind the official's back.
I didn't see that, but I would say that Tatanka's out. Let's go ahead and declare Ludwig the winner.
Something has to happen. Come on. Stop.
Look at this.
His finger on Tatanka's chest. I can't believe it.
What a way for a win streak to come to an indie beating with one finger. Stay in your seat. Don't go anywhere. Everything's all right. Everything's under control.
What's Borga doing? Borga is dragging Tatanka to the corner. Tatanka is still unconscious. I can't believe this stupid official hasn't called for medical attention.
They're not really doing anything to him. He's okay.
What is going on here?
Borga just to help Tatanka. And earlier on in the same hour, we saw the tag team of the Steiner brothers. They were padlocked in the dressing room. They were just released.
Wait a minute. That is not true. They were out there back there pushing on a door marked pull. That's how stupid they are. This is not a conspiracy. It's not some kind of scheme. The only thing is, looks like the elimination process of Survivor Series has started a little early. That's all.
Hopefully more information on Tatanka next week. And speaking of next week's,
come on, get down on one knee, will you? He finds out that you're not showing respect.
Well, what you gonna do?
He's gonna crown you more ways than one.
Yeah, he's a royal pain, all right. Burger King. Well, and Bret Hart gets his hands on him in Survivor Series, or before.
Another edition of the King's Court. And oh, I've got a very, very special guest tonight. This man is the Intercontinental Champion here in the World Wrestling Federation. And he calls himself the Bad Guy. Oh, yeah. Big deal. The only thing bad about this guy is his hair. It's got more oil in it than my car has. But I'm going to bring him out here anyway because I got a few hard questions I want to ask to Razor Ramon.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, as we mentioned, Jerry Lawler and his unknown knights to meet the Hart family of Survivor Series, but Razor Ramon will captain a quartet. That's
Survivor Series as well that features three men of the four that have held the Intercontinental Championship.
Who's going to host that family feud?
Rick Holmes.
Why didn't they ask me?
Just back away there just a little bit. We don't have to be too close. Been to the barber to get an oil change lately? Yeah, right. Hey, hey! Oh, you're real smart. You're real tough. I see you got all that gold around your neck, and now you got a little gold around your waist. Right, good deal. I want to know something. I want to know if you have declared all of this newfound weight, wealth that you've got here. I want to know if you've paid your taxes on all of this gold. Because if you haven't, there's a man right here in the World Wrestling Federation who is going to come and collect the taxes. I'm talking about Irwin R. Scheister. Show some respect.
Yo, IRS, you think the bad guy owes you something? Just try to collect.
Hey, he's going to do some collecting, but speaking of collecting, I want to talk to you about Survivor Series. You've collected, you're the bad guy. Well, you've collected a pretty bad team, in my opinion. The only thing bad about them is their breath. Now, let me tell you this. You talk about a team. You talk about a team that you're going to have to face at Survivor Series. What about the team that IRS has put together? It consists of himself. It consists of Diesel. It consists of Adam Bomb. That's right, and it consists of the model, Rick Martel. Now, there's a team for you. Do you think you can survive?
Hey, Thanksgiving Eve, Survivor Series, I got a team for you. I got Marty Jannetty, who has worn this gold before. I got the 1, 2, 3 kid. And believe me, Chico, I know that kid, he can beat anybody. And I got Perfecto. That's right. I got Mr. Perfect. And I have fought against him. I know how tough he is, and I want him in my corner.
Great team. He's gonna champ bad guy here, Brain.
You know there, King. I noticed you got your little pointy crown. You got a little gold of your own, man. But I don't see no gold around your chubby little waist. You call yourself the king.
Because I am the king.
You call yourself the king. Well, some people call me Razor. Some people call me bad guy. But from now on, everybody gotta call me champ.
the champ, Razor Ramon.
He is the champ, and that other man is the king, Jerry Lawler.
What a Survivor Series it's going to be, and we'll be back.
Let me ask you something, Ross. Look at that hairstyle. Isn't it from 1961?
World Wrestling Federation.
I don't know. Do I look like Fidel Sassoon or somebody?
Oh, you're from Oklahoma. You wouldn't know anything about that. I would call that hairstyle groovy.
Well, would you?
Not really.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the WWF Tag Team Championship on the line in just a few moments. There you see the champions. And there you see what the fans think of Johnny Polo's team. They're shocked. How would you like to be locked into a car on a long road trip with him?
Well, he's an obnoxious human being, and he's rude. But that's what I like about it. He gets under people's skin. He makes people irritable. I like Shock. I like Pierre. I like Johnny.
On their first chance, the Quebecers won the WWF Tag Team Championship. Will that be the case here for their opponents?
Well, everybody's crying about those Quebec province rules. Well, the same rules apply for them as it did the Steiners. They took advantage of the rules. Steiner should have taken advantage of it. Showed you who the smartest team is. Showed you who's packing the gold.
The mission.
Here come men on a mission led by their wrestling manager, Oscar. Coming up the steps, soon will be stepping over the top rope. 500 pounds, I would think, Bray.
At least. I'm going to quit this rapping and start scrapping. Wait a minute, I'm starting to rap now.
Like Jed Clampett there for a second.
Jed Clampett.
Said start, stop rapping and start scrapping. You all.
I don't know why I said that.
I saw you patting your foot, too. You must be liking Men on a Mission more and more every week.
I don't like rap music. I don't like country and western. I don't like anything like that. That's for people without an education.
All right, Men on a Mission in their first championship opportunity. You're seeing it right here. We're glad you're with us. It will be Jacques and Mo starting out here. That's the
moonwalk.
Yeah, that's the Canadian version of the moonwalk.
Well, you lose so much on the exchange.
Oh, is that it? I wonder what was wrong with it.
Nothing was wrong with it.
Well, this is an arrogant combination, and Mo was not too amused by Jacques' feeble attempt to moonwalk.
You know what amazes me about Mo and Mabel? They just grow hair in spots. There's not really a good hunk of hair anyway. It just grows in spots.
Well, I think that's their style. I think that... Looks like Jacques is growing his hair in spots, too, but that's another story.
Well, he's got different spots.
Side headlock applied by Mo. As our camera looks over the shoulder of the manager of this tag team camp. It's a good shoulder block there. Well, Jacques is an outstanding athlete and a very sound technical wrestler, but he can't overpower either of these men, especially Mabel.
You see, when you see Mo, you think he's the smallest one on the team, which he is. But he's still bigger than most people. It's that Mabel is so huge. Mo's got to go, what, around 300 pounds, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, the Pierre weighs in about 292, and I would say that as we'll look right here, we'll get a good comparison. Mabel and, Mo and Pierre are very close in stature.
Oh, they've got to be both around 300 pounds.
No doubt about it.
I mean poundage, I'm an IQ.
Well, tag was made and the champions are celebrating, but look who's coming to dinner here.
Mr. Meat and Potatoes right behind you.
Well, Pierre not quite so enthusiastic. Man, Mabel is huge.
chance to win the big Intercontinental Battle Royal several weeks ago.
It's not always the big guy that wins. Look at this. Look at that.
Jock trying a cheap shot. That's not going to work. And from behind comes Pierre, and that didn't work. And up on Mabel's back is Jock.
Come on, Pierre, jump on the front.
And Pierre doesn't want any of it. Now, Mayor Takeover, look out. Jock is leaving the premises, and we've got to leave momentarily. Don't you go away. This title match will continue.
Yeah, come on. Come on, Pierre. Knock him down.
Welcome back, everyone. Jim Ross and Bobby the Brain Heenan back with you. And even though Pierre got a full head of steam off the ropes, and then a drop kick by the 500-pounder. Can you believe that? Pierre's unbelievable, Brain.
How'd he get off the mat?
Oh, what an athletic move by 500-pound man. That was tremendous. That was phenomenal. And Mabel tags in Mo. Mabel steps over the top rope. Comes out here on the apron. With a polo coming up. Polo and Jacques are both where they don't need to be. And from behind came Pierre. Now he's going to try to gain the advantage, and he's doing so on Mo here in this WWF Tag Team Championship match. Front face lock by Pierre. And now the Quebecers back in control, Brain.
Clean a horse or a cow or those barns you hang around. This is big time.
Well, no doubt it is big time. You can see the capacity crowd on hand here.
Quebecers depend a lot on double teaming.
Yeah, look at this move. Nice double team move there by the Quebecers. The crowd was chanting, "Let's go, Mo."
And, of course, you know, today's competition in the WWF, all tag team wrestling.
He's got him. No, he doesn't.
I didn't think you could hold him either. But you know, the competition today, everything is double team. Everybody takes advantage of the rules, so you've got to fight fire with fire.
Scoop slam by Pierre makes the exchange with Jacques. Now more double team. Look at this move!
Oh!
Up and over. The elevation. He's got it now. The cover by Jacques. Only a one count.
I've never seen anybody kick out of that. That's usually one of their finishing moves.
Jacques now brings Mo into the corner. And look at Pierre's choking Mo over here, the right part of your screen. A referee being detained over here with Jacques and Mabel. But in the meantime, Mo's being choked, Ray.
Well, you see, that's Jacques' job right there. Keep the referee entertained. Make sure you try to get the big dummy Mabel in the ring so all the referee's attention is drawn to that corner. Meanwhile, Pierre can do the damage. Good tag team wrestling.
Modified pile driver there by Jacques. On Mo, of men on a mission. And Jacques makes another exchange.
It's over.
Or it could be over right here. Oh, this is devastating here, ladies and gentlemen. Pierre's about 300 pounds. Up on the top. And nobody there. Mo able to sit out. And nobody there. Here comes Mabel.
Pierre is hurt.
Referee putting Mabel back outside. Wait a minute, what's Polo doing? Trying to get Pierre up. I think Pierre's the leading man in this match, as is Mo. Both men could be well served to make the tag. What's Jacques doing in there? Is he the legal man, Brain?
One of the Quebecers is the legal man.
Well, Mabel has gotten the tag.
Whoa.
And Mabel just ran through Jacques. Irish whip far side in a high elevation. Quarterback body drop there. And a clothesline by Mabel. Remember, ladies and gentlemen, this big man's about 500 pounds. The Quebecers in danger, in dire straits here, of losing the WWF Tag Team title.
It don't look good. I think the referee's lost control of this match.
And look at Jacques out there accosting Oscar for no reason.
Oh, you can accost Oscar for any reason. Just him being there is good enough to accost Oscar.
Mabel is on the outside. Mabel's a legal man. The referee is counting Mabel, Brain.
Maybe he's counting Jacques. I don't know what's going on.
Mabel and Pierre, the legal men in the match.
I thought it was Jacques and the just wait and see here. You didn't see Johnny Polo jumping in the ring like Oscar did, did you?
Here are your winners as a result of a countout.
I thought so. I thought that the Memphis were on the outside.
Well, you're right. They won the match, but they're still in the goal. They did not win the title.
Decision is a count out victory for Men on a Mission. But as you know,
the gold stays with the Quebecer. Now it's up to the WWF officials to approach these three right here and try to get that gold away from them.
Well, if this match had been contested under Quebec province rules, we would have had new tag team champions, but that was not the case.
That's right. This is not Quebec province rules.
Well, the referee trying to explain now to Men on a Mission exactly what happened as we go face to face.